God has been making miracles to reach the world for him, so that the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ, his death, his burial, his resurrection, may be known to all mankind. And when that happens, then he will come and bring his followers with him in heaven. In doing this, we need to understand the Word of God. And the Word of God is only found in the Scriptures, the Bible. The Bible, which we know a moving library, because this Bible, it contains 66 books, and it is divided into two. And these two divisions are the Old Testament and the New Testament. There are a lot of things that we can gain in reading the Word of God. And at this time, I'd like to speak only two of this. Number one, to be challenged. What is this challenge? It is a question mark that we will expound later on. And number two is that to grow in hope. This is our life. We are dealing with hope. Our future, we're dealing with hope. Good reading in its importance is that to be challenged. In Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12, it says this: "For the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing apart of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart." The word of God is sharper than what kind of sword? Two-edged sword, double blade. What does this word of God can do to us? It says here that piercing even to the dividing apart of the soul and spirit. Do you know that there are three parts of man? Well, this is another topic, and it is a large topic, but I will give you the basic view of this, wherein a person has the body, it has the soul and the spirit. Don't be confused, because the soul and the spirit are two different. These are two different parts of a person. Now, what is this body? This is the body. Now, this body, when it dies, it goes back to where it came from. Without the soul and the spirit, it doesn't feel anything. Death is a separation. That's the meaning of death. And what happened when this body dies? The spirit and the soul separate from it. So death comes into this body. Even though you cut this body into pieces, it doesn't feel anything, because what it can feel is the soul, that soul. How about the spirit? The spirit is the one that God has given to you, that when this soul separates from this body, when this body dies, it goes back to the Father, and the soul will go to two directions, whether destruction or paradise. Now, what does it say in here? The sword, the word of God, it penetrates between the soul and the spirit. Can you imagine how powerful the word of God is? It changes man. It keeps us alive. It brings us hope. This is the word of God. And of the joints and marrow, and is discerning of thoughts and intents of the heart. So we can see in here that the word of God, when you listen to it, well, you will come to think, what's this? There are a lot of persons already who testify that through reading the word of God, they are changed. And there are some unbelievers, atheists, who don't believe in God, wherein they wanted to research, to destruct and destroy the Bible. But in order to do that, they have to read into it, right? But while they are reading it, you know what happened? They are being taught and became believers of God, because it is right. The word of God is sharper than the two-edged sword. It challenges us. My late wife, Evangeline Vance, who went with the Lord, we've been together for 35 years. But you know, if you have a partner in life, he is not only your friend, he is also your teacher. So for that 35 years, every time I stand on the pulpit, she listens. After that, she corrects me. So she is my teacher. But then later on, it seems like she has a stronger faith than me. And I said, "What happened? You've been went through a reading a lot." "No." "You know what? Every time I correct you, I listen to your teaching. While I search for any mistakes, as I listen, I'm being taught. So I learn from your sermons. The words that I speak to you are spirit and are life. Can you see that? No wonder why, when Jesus was a visitor of these two sisters, Martha and Maria, Martha was busy in the kitchen preparing for food. And then Jesus is in the living room talking to the other people. And as he talks, she was teaching them. And Maria was there. So Martha was bothered. When Martha was bothered, she complains to Jesus. Jesus, you know it's hard to prepare food. I'm here in the kitchen and my sister is there sitting beside you. And Jesus said, well, Maria is in a better place. You know why? She was listening to the word of God. So he is in a better position. Why? Because the word of God is alive. They are what? Spirit and life. Man could not live by bread alone, but by the word of God.